Hello students, welcome to our English class. I am Miss Annie Ithur and today we are going to learn 3.1 The Plate of Gold Part 2. So students, in previous video, that is the Part 1, we have learned that the Plate of Gold is by James Henry Leigh Hunt. He is an English poet, essayist, journalist, editor, writer and critic, as well as prominent figure of romantic movement in England. The Plate of Gold by James Henry Leigh Hunt is a poem about men's love for God. Through this poem, Hunt aims to make people understand that service towards mankind is true service towards God. Only a man who loves all human beings alike can love God to the fullest. We also learn that the poem is a narrative that begins with a plate of gold falling in the temple court of Banaras. The plate of gold was a gift from heaven to the one who loved God the best. The priest of the temple decided to award the plate to the one who was virtuous and merciful. Then they made an announcement and people from every corner came to claim the plate for themselves. After that, we have learned that the priests judged a lot of people over the course of year and finally awarded the plate to a man who was, according to them, the largest lover of mankind, because he had distributed his entire esteem among the poor. However, the plate turned to lead the minute the priest handed it over to the claimant. When the claimant dropped the plate, it turned again to the gold plate. So now, let's learn the remaining part which is left of the poem. So now let's get started with the poem. Poem 3.1, The Plate of Gold, of your English Balbharati textbook. The passage starts from page number 58 and 59, that is, "And now the second till the love of God." Now, let's get started with the lesson. For every pilgrim, the temple gate prays God that love might thus approve itself before the test, and so coins rent freely in the outstretched hand. But none of those who gave so much has turned to look into the poor sad eyes of them that begged. So every pilgrim was praising God, and they were praising God because their love towards God will prove, and how much and how it will be proved to God, by giving alms to beggars. So they were giving coins to the beggars and doing lots of things to the beggars who were present on the street. So what they were feeling by doing that, that God will love us, or God will love us in such a way, and he will think us that we are capable of getting this heaven gift. So that is why coins rent freely in the outstretched hands. Outstretched means stretch or spread out as far as possible. But whoever people came to give the beggars to donate the coins, none of them thought that the poor people to whom they are donating their coins to look into their eyes, that how much sad they are, how much pain they have inside them. In spite of looking them, they were just giving them coin, and nobody thought of doing that. Next, And now the second year has almost passed, but still the plate of gold by whomsoever touched was turned to lead. At length there came a simple pleasant, not aware of that strange contest for the gift of God, to pay a vow within the temple. As he passed along the line of shriveled beggars, all his soul was moved within him to sweet pity, and the tears welled up and trembled in his eyes. So second year also passed, but whoever came to claim the plate and touch that plate, it turned into lead. It turned into cheapest metal. At length means after a long time. So the peasant was not knowing about the strange contest that was happening in the temple. So as we have seen in the paragraph, contents means you can say that the gift that was sent by God on earth to whom love the most, or you can say that it was a blessing from the God for that person. So that was not the competition that he will donate more, will only get this gift from God. It was like a blessing, and this man had come to take the blessing of God. To pay vow means to give oneself or surround oneself for service of God. So as the man was going in the temple, he saw many beggars sitting near the temple. Shriveled means dry up and rejected. So as we have learned that beggars were having different kinds of disease. Okay, they were dried up and they were also rejected by many people. So all these beggars were there on the road, and as he saw his body shriveled after looking those beggars, because the beggars were not getting proper nourishment. And after seeing these beggars, the peasant was moved from within, okay, and he felt a sweet pity on them, and his eyes were full of tears after looking the beggars that were on the street. Next. Now, by the temple gate, there lay a poor, sore creature, blind and shunned by all. But when the peasant came and saw the sightless face and trembling maimed hands, he could not pass, but kneeled and took both palms in his hand, and softly said, "O thou, my brother, bear thy troubles bravely. God is good." Then he arose and walked straight away across the court and entered where the wrangled of their deeds of love before the priest. So as the peasant was passing, he saw a poor, sore creature, sore means person whose body parts are paining. And he was blind. Shunned means avoided and rejected. So he was rejected by all and avoided by all, and he was kept alone. And as the peasant saw the poor sightless face, a person who cannot see, sight means vision. So when the peasant saw the sightless beggar, then he was trembled and shriveled, means whose hands are damaged. Okay, maybe his hands were not proper. So as he saw, he could not able to pass from there, because he was very sad after looking them. And there itself, after looking them, okay, looking this beggar, he kneeled and took both his hands of the poor in his hands very sweetly, in soft manner, like a lovely affection, and softly said him, "O thou, my brother, bear thy troubles bravely." Thou is the old English word. It means you, my brother. Thy is yours. So the peasant is telling him, whatever troubles, okay, and whatever problems you have, face it bravely. God is good, because he looks everything and he will do good for you. So after telling this, he rose and walked straight away to the court and entered where people were coming to tell their deeds. Okay, so he entered where the priest and the people were gathered. Okay, and so he did the same thing. Okay, and he entered. Okay, and there he saw they wrangled. Wrangled means argued angrily. So that means they were telling angrily, okay, and talking angrily with the priest that I have done this, I have done that. So the plate should be of mine because I have donated more and all this. Okay, so they were telling like this to the priest in an angry mood. So they were talking about their donation done to the poor in such a way that they were they have done a world's big work. Usually it is said that when we give something to someone with one hand, then other hand should not know about this. So when you donate, you should not declare that to everyone that I have done this or that. Okay, it's like a show off that you do. So if you do declare, then there is no value or importance of that donation. So you should not do that. So the same thing, the people who had come to tell their deeds were doing the same thing in the temple court. Next. As a while he listened sadly, then had turned away, but something moved the priest who held the plate of gold to beckon to the peasant who came, not understanding, and obeyed, and stretched his hand and took the sacred vessel. So the peasant waited there to see what's happening, and after listening he got sad because there were arguments going on in the court, and as he listened to them he turned back to go from there. So as he turned away to go, the priest saw him and he thought of calling that man again. So now don't know what happened to the priest. He calls that peasant again. Okay, so he did the same thing as the priest called him. He obeyed and came back, not understanding what's happening, but still he went there and stretched his hand to take what priest is giving. So he stretched his hand and took the sacred vessel. Sacred means holy, pure. So this was the sacred vessel, the holy vessel that was from heaven. Lo, it shone with thrice its former luster and amazed them all. Son, cried the priest, rejoice, the gift of God is thine. Thou lovest best, and all made answer, it is well, and one by one departed. But the peasant kneeled and prayed, bowing his head above the golden plate, while over his soul, like morning, streamed the love of God. Now here lo, an exclamatory is given. So here it is used to draw the attention of interesting or amazing event. So the same thing, it was interesting event going on in the temple court where the claimant were coming to claim the golden plate, but nobody could claim that plate because as they were touching, it was turning into basset lead. But as this peasant touched that golden plate, it didn't change its color. It was as it is. Luster means shine. So still it was shining after his touch. And by looking at this, everyone, whoever were present in the court, were amazed. They were shocked. And finally, the priest rejoiced because finally, after 2 years, their work had been done which God had given to them. And the priest told the peasant that, son, take this. This is the gift of God which has come from heaven. You are loving God the most. And after that, everyone made an answer and told, yes, it's right, because this is the right person to have this golden plate. And everyone after that started departing, means started going from there. But the peasant did not gone from there. He kneeled and prayed, and with the he kneeled with the golden plate and bowed his head in front of that golden plate, because it was the plate of God. And as he bowed his head in front of golden plate, he thought as if God has blessed him, given his light, okay, light like a morning shining rays, as if the God had blessed this man with his powerful blessing. Okay, students, so now this is a very beautiful poem by James Henry Leigh Hunt. I hope, students, you have understood this lesson and have got message from this lesson. Now, students, let's quickly do the questions which are there on the page number 59 and 60. That is your English workshop. So, our first question, pick out words from the poem to complete the sentences meaningfully. So, the first one, Stephen Hawking was a dash famous astrophysicist. So, the answer is renowned. Second, the government made a dash announcement about their new taxation policy. So, the answer is proclamation. Third, everyone stood horrified when the terrible accident took place. So, the answer is aghast. Fourth one, she dash bargained with the hawker to reduce the price. So, the answer is wrangled. Fifth one, handicapped people should never be dash ignored and avoided. So, the answer is shunned. So, students, after looking the words which are given in the bracket and the answers which you have to find from the textbook, it means that are in the form of antonym. So, now the second question, which two sayings about God are conveyed through the poem, The Plate of Gold? So, the first is, God helps those who help themselves. Second, God loves those who love their fellow beings. Third, God loves those who give away their wealth to please Him. Fourth, service to mankind is service to God. So, from this four, you have to find out the two lines which says about God that has been conveyed through this poem. So, the B and D are the two sentences that are being conveyed through the poem. B is, God loves those who love their fellow beings. And fourth is, service to mankind is service to God. So, these are the two pairs, okay, two sentences. Third question, answer the following question. First, to whom did the priest give the plate of gold? So, the answer is, the priest gave the plate of gold to the simple peasant. Second, what magical occurrence shocked the people? Answer is, when the plate of gold was handed to the simple peasant, it shone with thrice its luster and surprised everyone standing there. Third one, why did the pilgrims to the temple shower coins to the beggars? Answer is, whichever claimant came to the temple court, they showered the coins to the beggars so that they thought, when we will give to the poor, God will make us capable of that golden plate. And because of this reason, they were showering their coins to the beggar. Fourth one, what was the poor peasant reaction on seeing the lines of shriveled beggars? So, the answer is, on seeing the line of the shriveled beggars, he was deeply moved by pity for them and tears welled up in his eyes. Fifth one, Why had God chosen the simple peasant as the most deserving of the plate of gold? So the answer is, God chose the simple peasant as the most deserving of the plate of gold because the simple peasant shows qualities of such as empathy for the least of his burden and indifference towards worldly material wealth. He spent time with the blind beggars and offered him consolation and courage. Fourth question, identify and explain the figure of speech in the following line. First one, the second year had almost passed, but still the plate of gold by whomsoever touched was turned to lead. The figure of speech is imaginary because the poet uses descriptive imagery to make the poem appealing from the readers. Second, at length there came a simple peasant, not aware of the strange contest for the gift of God, to pay a vow within the temple. The figure of speech is inversion because the word in the line have been rearranged for poetic effect. The correct order should be, at the length there came a simple peasant to pay a vow within the temple, not aware of the strange contest for the gift of God. Third one, and the tears welled up and trembled in his eyes. The figure of speech is personification because the tears have been given the human qualities of trembling. Fourth one, then he arose and walked straight away across the court and entered where the wrangled of their deeds of love before the priest. The figure of speech is onomatopoeia because the word wrangled donates the sound made by the angry people who were arguing. That's all for today. I hope students you have understood the lessons as well as the questions we have discussed today. You can write this into your notebook. Thank you, students. God bless you. Remain safe.